Hello students, I am Samuel sir and we are in the third chapter of our civics textbook and the chapter's name is the state government. We are going to see how the state government functions in this chapter. Now you know that there are three levels of government in India. We have the central government, we have the state governments and we have the local governments. The power and extent of authority of the state governments has been clearly defined in our constitution, right? And laws for governing the states are made by its legislative assembly, and we are going to see how this is done. So we have bicameral type of legislature. We have the two houses, the upper house and the lower house, or we have the Lok Sabha and the Vidhan Sabha. That is the structure of the Indian government. The structure is like this. There is a legislature. Legislature means the process of making and passing laws. Now, a legislature is a formally chosen body of people. Now, these people have the power. They have been given the authority to make rules and regulations. At state level, the legislature is either unicameral or bicameral. Now, we'll see what it means. Unicameral means only one house. And bicameral means two houses. So we have lower house, that in Hindi we call it as Vidhan Sabha, and lower house is also known as the legislative assembly. Similarly, we have the upper house, which in Hindi is known as Vidhan Parishad, and upper house is also known as the legislative council. Now the bigger states or the states which are more populous are having bicameral type of legislature, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Jammu and Kashmir, which now has become a union territory. Maharashtra, Karnataka and Uttar Pradesh are examples. Now in this flowchart, the one which is on the extreme right is not included in our chapter. That is judiciary, we are not talking about that, but about the executive and the legislature. In executive, we have the governance of the state, and in legislature, we have the lawmaking. This is what we are talking about in this chapter. About the legislative council, now let's see how the election of the members is done. Only in seven states, the legislative council or Vidhan Parishad can be found. And the members are known as the members of Legislative Council. And they are not directly elected. They are indirectly elected. Let's see how. One third of the members are elected by the MLAs. And MLAs are directly elected. You should know that. And one third members are elected by the local bodies. One twelfth the members are elected by the graduates living in the state. And a similar number, that is 1/12, by the teachers of secondary schools, colleges and universities. Now the remaining 1/6 are nominated by the governor. And the Legislative Council is a permanent body. And for that reason, only 1/3 of the members retire every second year. So that makes every member of the Legislative Council, every MLC has got a tenure of 6 years as a member of the Legislative Council. Now, the Legislative Council is presided by the chairman. If he is not there, if he is absent, then the deputy chairman takes care of the meetings and the proceedings. Now, let's look at the Legislative Assembly. The states are divided into smaller areas known as constituencies. Now, these are the constituencies. These are for the sake of elections of the members of the legislative assemblies. We have the constituencies. Now, the voters elect one representative. You know, as soon as you become 18 years of age, or if your age is more than that, you can make an voter ID card and you can choose your own representative. We can cast a vote and choose. So we select one representative from the constituency in which we live to the Legislative Assembly. such elected people then become the MLAs or the members of the Legislative Assembly. The number of seats depend on the population of the state, but it is certainly between 60 and 500. It cannot be 59, it cannot be 501. Now the constitution defines how much that will be. The governor can nominate a member of Anglo-Indian community when they are not adequately represented. You also know that the political party with more than 50% of the constituencies is said to be in majority, and they form the government. And such party which is in the majority, they are known as the ruling party. Sometimes it so happens that a single party does not get a majority. So what it does is, it joins hands with two or more like-minded parties, and then they form a government. If they form a government like that, such a government is known as coalition government. Coalition means in cooperation. Right? So the rest of the members elected to the Legislative Assembly are called as opposition. If you are not from the ruling party, you are in the opposition. Now the Legislative Assembly has a tenure of 5 years. But it can be dissolved earlier also if the circumstances are not right. The assembly can be dissolved earlier, in less than 5 years. Now all the meetings of the Legislative Assembly are presided over by the Speaker. And if he is not there, if he is absent for some reason, then the Deputy Speaker takes over. The Speaker and the Deputy Speaker takes votes on issues and also maintains law and order in the House. They decide which things are to be discussed in priority. After the election results are declared, and the Governor invites the leader of the party with majority to form a government. The MLAs of the winning party elect a leader, and this person now becomes a chief minister, right? So who is making a person as chief minister? The MLAs of the winning party, they decide who will be their leader, who can rule the state. The chief minister selects his ministers. Now it's now his job, the chief minister's job. He gives portfolios. He coordinates the functioning of various departments. He says, all right, this minister will be for agriculture, this minister will be for health, this minister for education, this minister for public works, and so on and so forth. The minister who heads various departments represents the government in the Legislative Assembly, and they are responsible for execution of the laws. The chief minister and other ministers together run the affairs of the government. We're talking about a state government, remember that. And the governor is the nominal head of the state. He is appointed by the president for 5 years. Now, you remember this, that the governor is not a man from the state government. He is a man from the central government, man or woman from the central government. And he is appointed by the president. He is directly reporting to the president. His work is to oversee the working of the state government. Is everything going all right? And he is the representative of the central government. He has got one more work which we'll be seeing shortly. Now, how does a bill become a law? Bill is a proposal. Sometimes new laws have to be made. New laws and rules and regulations have to be made. Sometimes the old ones have to be changed. Sometimes some modifications have to be done. So how it is done? First, a bill is introduced and there's a committee which hears what it is, and an action is taken on that, and again it's sent to the other house. The lower house sends it to the upper house, and there they have another committee hearing and a floor action. And if passed with amendments, it goes to the original house, and then it goes to the governor. And if the governor signs it, if he feels it's all right, it's beneficial for the people, he signs it, whether this way or that way, if it is beneficial, he signs it, and then it becomes a law. Most of the bills become law from the January 1st of the next year. But sometimes, as in case of this COVID-19 situation that the world is having now, and India is also part of it, we do not wait for 1st of January. In fact, we find the changes happening so frequently. Every 15 days, there are some new laws, new rules, new regulations meant for the safety of the people. Here's a summary of the working of the state government and working of the working of state government, both for Vidhan Sabha and for Vidhan Parishad. So I want you all to read this and write it down also. You should know these facts. These are important for your examination. I'm just dwelling on it for a long time so that you can pause your screen and note it down. Now, we look at the governor as the functionary of the state. He is the nominal head of the state and he is appointed by the president, as we already said, and it's for 5 years' time. The term can be extended or it can be shortened as the case may be or as the need may be, but the decision is taken by the president. The governor of a state corresponds to the president of a nation. What a governor is to the state is the same as what the president of India is to the nation. All bills passed by the legislative, the state legislature, have to be approved and signed by the governor. He is the final signing authority. So here in this, you can see the governor is above the legislature, and legislature has got two parts: the Legislative Assembly and the Legislative Council. Now we look at the second functionary of the state, that is the Chief Minister. The Chief Minister is the real head of the state, and he or she advises the governor on the Council of Ministers to be selected, how many they are to be, and what their functions are to be. It can also differ from state to state and from place to place. The CM assigns portfolios to the ministers, and he also appoints a deputy chief minister. That is, if required, if the state is a big state, and if the chief minister requires that there should be another man just below him, he appoints a deputy chief minister also. The chief minister is responsible for running all the affairs of the state efficiently. Now, the next functionaries of the state, they are the Council of Ministers. Now, including the Chief Minister, the Council of Ministers cannot be more than 15% of the members of the Legislative Assembly. So, if the number of MLAs is 100, then it means that the number of Council of Ministers cannot be more than 15. That is 15 per 100. The Council of Ministers is divided into three categories. One is the cabinet minister, the other is the minister of the states, the state and deputy ministers. A cabinet minister can hold one or more portfolios, and he is assisted by the minister of state and or the deputy minister. The MLAs, they meet in the Vidhan Sabha and they discuss matters concerning the states, they debate upon it, they take decisions upon it. And they all do that in the meetings in the Vidhan Sabha. The decisions can be such as what is to be taxed, how much is to be taxed, what is to be exempted, should concessions should be given for certain items, how panchayat should be formed. All these are examples of matters discussed in the Vidhan Sabha by the MLAs. Now, MLAs also put question to the government during the meetings. And the concerned minister has to reply to them. For example, if they are asking about the appointment of teachers, then the minister who is looking after the education department has to answer. If there's a question about the health of people or epidemics or vaccination or about such anything that has to do with health, then the Minister of Health has to answer. Now, every question does not satisfy every MLA. It is but natural. And the speaker coordinates the discussions. The speaker is the one who is coordinating. His job is to ensure that everybody gets time to present their opinion and the MLAs listen to each other peacefully. He is like the class monitor. And he can decide also in which order the discussion has to be taken place and which issues have to be discussed, which are the currently important issues that is decided by the speaker. Now, how a law is implemented? Now, what is a gazette? The gazette is the law. The law is published in a book. You know, that book is known as gazette. All right. So, gazette is a book. That is a book of laws. It is sent to the government officials. After the law is made, it is sent to the government officials for implementation. For example, it is sent to a collector of a district, if it is meant for that particular district. From then onwards, it becomes the collector's responsibility to ensure that the law gets implemented. For implementation, then he will take the help of the, let us say, the police, or let us say the health department or the education department. He will be taking help of those departments for the implementation of the law. Now, what are the functions of the government? The MLAs, they make, they amend, they ratify the laws in the legislative assembly. Now, a bill, a proposal for a new law. What is a bill? It is a proposal for a new law or to amend an existing one. If there's one which is already there and it has to be modified, can be introduced in any house. It can be done in the Vidhan Sabha or it can be also done in the Vidhan Parishad or in the Legislative Assembly or in Legislative Council. Once a bill is reached in one of these houses, the members debate over it. They look at it from all the angles, all the point of views, and they make changes and vote for it. After they make changes, they vote for it. Some may be in favor, some may not be in favor. When both the houses approve it, the bill is sent to the governor. And the bill becomes law when the governor examines it. After examining it with everybody's consent, with everybody's knowledge, he signs it. Only then the bill becomes a law. The function of the government is also about the chief minister. The chief minister and his ministers, they do not make laws. They are not the ones who are making the laws. It is the legislative assembly and the council which is making the laws. But they are accountable to the people. Both the chief minister and the his ministers, his council of ministers, they have to reply to the people. They implement laws related to agriculture, public work, law and order, revenue, through various departments and so on. And they are answerable to the opposition party as well, because opposition party is closely monitoring, closely watching how the ruling party is managing the affairs of the states. And they are also answerable to the media, because media is the one which is connecting them to the people. And media questions them on behalf of the people. If the people are not happy with the functioning of the chosen government, they can voice their displeasure and they can demand that the laws be changed. This is the end of the chapter. If you don't understand anything, when we have our online classes, you can ask me and give it a thumbs up and wait for the next video. Bye.